coming up, gonna be a bright new day.
Originally introduced in mid-1982 when the city was still reeling from the recession, the flashy campaign was a wake-up call for a slumbering city. As Mayor Sloan's communications director, Jeffrey Hutter, helped introduce the ads.
The original purpose, quite basically, was to respond to some community surveys that to a great extent showed that Louisvillians did not feel the community was progressive, they didn't feel progressing, they didn't feel that it was on the right track.
It's hard to gauge the success of this kind of campaign, but Hutter believes the popular spots did more than make a celebrity of singer Hazel Miller.
There was one poll taken by the Louisville Times about a half year into the first phase of the Pride campaign, and that showed a very high number, I think, maybe two-thirds of the people who responded said that the slogan and the song and the campaign did make them feel a little bit better about Louisville, and it did sort of show them some things.
Now the ads are back with a more low-key approach. Interviews with people involved with successful companies.
Look in the newspapers and say, hey, that's us. And I had some part of it.
Now we're really hoping that the accomplishments of the community will speak to the issue of pride more so than the song or the theme.
Louisville is really the heart beat of our air operation.
The $30,000 cost of the spots was approved by the Board of Aldermen. Hutter says none of the local stations was worried about whether the ads would be seen as political, even though Sloan is involved in the campaign for judge executive.
We've been very careful, as you would see in all the spots, that the mayor has not been in them. He is not anywhere in these spots. They are not city government commercials. They're about activities, projects, developments in the community.